Hi, I'm Gary from Gary's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make different backgrounds with shimmer powder. I have done another video where I used the powder as a paint, and I will link to that at the video at the top. I will start with just one color, and I spray the card and turn it over and spray the other side against warping. And then I add the shimmer powder by tapping on the bottle, and I will add it mostly at the top. And you can also see why you need to store the bottles up straight, because the powder will get in the cap and falls out when you open it. Then I spray some more water to activate the powder, and I dry it with a heat tool. I spray some more water to help the color move. And then I add a bit more powder because I want the top darker. And I keep drying and spraying water to get texture and color. Just so you know, I added the main products I used in the description box for you. You can also find the full list of supplies on my new blog. We are still building on the website, but the blog is as good as done. So hop on over if you want to take a peek. The link is also in the description box below this video. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. Adding the power in layers and drying in between also adds to create the depth in the design. I add a bit more powder at the top to get that deep dark color. And I blend it out to the bottom to keep it very light, with just a hint of color. So here's the first background, I will finish it later. For the next background I use three colors to make sort of a night sky. I use the Nouveau Light Mist spray bottle to spray the card on both sides. And this is what you get when the bottle falls over. Some powder will be in the cap and it comes out when you open it. And here's even more than on the first card. And when this happens, just work with it. I add the black color and the blue. And then I'm going to spray water and I tilt the page to move the colors a bit. And I blot the sides to take away the big blobs of color. And then I dry it with the heat tool. I spray more water to move and blend the colors. And this also gives some texture. If you like it better without the texture, just add the powder, spray some water, and dry with the heat tool or let it air dry. Spray a bit more water and add powder on the spots that are lighter and mix the black and the blue a bit. And this is just playing around. It's fun to see how the powders react. And if you like what you get, just stop or add a bit more color if you like that better. And when I spray water, I not only spray the complete card, I also spray it on little spots just to move tiny space with color on the card. And here you can see the blue mixed with the black, and this gives so much depth, it's really cool and so easy to make and fun too, very important. And now the bottom with the mixed color, and this is so pretty because you add the purple and then you see purple, pink and blue colors when you add water. I spray the water and let the colors move, and I dry and I blot and I add some more color. I like my backgrounds very colorful, but you can also go for just a big splat in the middle if you want to keep it simple. So here's the second background, and look at all that gorgeous shimmer. Another background with two colors now. I spray the card again, and now I add the first color in the middle. I spray some water to activate the powder again. And then I add the second color around it. and then I'm going to dry the card. I spray some more water to blend and get more texture. And here's the third background with a bright yellow, your eyes are drawn to the center. And now the last background. I start with spraying the card again, and now I'm going to make a sort of ombre background. And for this I just start with one color. I spray water to activate the powder, and then I add some more powder and more water, and then I'm going to dry it. Then I spray some water on the powder that is on my desk, and I pick up the color with the card on the parts where there's still some white left. I'm still not good with white. I clean the desk and my card is dry, and now I'm going to add the second color. I just spray the bottom now and then add a color, and then spray water to activate the powder again. And I dry it with a heat tool. You can also let it air dry. The heat tool is just to speed things up. And here's my last background after drying. Now let's turn the backgrounds into cards. I've drawn a piece of vellum and I fold that around the card. I add tape to the back to keep it in place. I add the card to the make art station and then add a magnetic ruler to line up the printed sentiment. Then I move the ruler so I can add the letters I cut out of metal craft stock. The ruler really helps to line up the letters. I glue the letters in place using Tonicraft tacky glue, and this has a super fine tip which is great to add glue on small pieces like these letters, and it dries clear, so no worries if some glue pops out from under the letter. And here's the card so far. I added it to a white note card. I have pre-made some nouveau drops, and I use the same drops as a glue to add them on the card. This way the vellum doesn't warp and the drops are dry in a jiffy. So here's the finished card where the background still shows. For the next card I'm going to add some black stickles to the bottom, just a wonky line like uneven soil. And now I'm going to add two deer I cut with a Nordic winter die. They are in black and they stand out really nice against the black and grey background. I'm going to make a sentiment and I line up the letters on a sticky note. Just another way to cut a sentiment out of a card. The letters should be added from right to left to read as a mirror word, if that's the right way to say it. To check, you can turn it and hold it against the light to see if you added them the right way or hold it in front of the mirror. Then I use the station again with the ruler to add it straight on the card. And then I rub the sticky note on the card so it stays in place. I add some tape on the back where the dies are and then I run it through the machine, just the top part where the letters are, and best is to do this first, of course, duh. And there you go, a nice sentiment. I take off the dies and then I add a piece of silver craft stock to the back. And I put the little cutouts back in place. I added cards to the make art station and I add the big letters that I cut out with double sided adhesive to the back, so they make great stickers. Peel away half of the backing of the G so it doesn't stick to the ruler, but I'm still able to add it to the card. Here's another card done. Real simple and easy to do. For the next card, I color a piece of ultra smooth card with embellishment mousse using a sponge. I let this dry, this goes really fast, like 5 minutes or so, and then I tear the paper to make sort of tiny hills. I add a few trees, also cut with a Nordic winter die. Now I'm going to add the hills, let's just call them that, and then add the rest of the trees, making sort of a winter scenery. I cut some stars out of card colored with shimmer powder and I add those at the top. I added the background to a black note card and now some glue at the bottom of the card, just below the torn bit. And I'm going to add the distressed mica flakes. These shiny flakes are in various sizes, from bigger bits to small. Just sprinkle them on and then shake them off. Move the bits if needed and then let them dry. They just add some pretty sparkle. For the last card, I cut a bunch of the Tim Holtz garden greens out of white card and I glue them in place first. And with cards like this, when the background is pretty, I don't want to add too much, and the white really makes the color pop even more. I cut off the bits that are sticking out. I cut a word out of white ultra smooth card with double-sided adhesive on the back to make stickers again. And I use the make card station also again to add the letters to the card. And for this card I want to keep it simple like this with just one word. And this is the finished card. I added it on a white note card. And here are all the cards together with lots of shimmer. I hope you are inspired to get all shimmery yourself and rush to your craft space to treat yourself to some craft time. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and make sure to keep on crafting.